Is that where the name came from?
Oh, Ron, yeah. So my granddad, Ron.
That's my name.
What, Aaron?
Yeah, that's why I kept... You go, Aaron, come here.
I got two Aarons in the house. Yeah.
Boy, it looks sick.
This might not happen, so get your head around it.
You mad.
My goalkeeper's in the house. Come on, Keeps. Goalie.
It's good to see you, man.
Did they play table tennis at England?
Nah.
What about basketball?
Yeah, I'll beat you at that.
You won't beat me at that? Oh. I'm just so glad to see you. Look at you. You're looking well. Everything cool?
Yeah, man.
How's your family, man? That's what's important.
Yeah, they're good.
They're in Paris.
They're in Paris?
See my brother, yeah.
Chilling?
Yeah.
Is your brother live in Paris?
Nah, he's on tour doing acting.
Seriously?
Yeah, yeah.
Like proper theatre actor?
Yeah, theatre.
What's he been in?
I toured with Cats, did Cats in London, Billy Elliot. And...
Wow, I like that. I like the fact that he's acting because it's something that I'd like to do, but I'm scared to do because
really?
I wouldn't remember the lines, bro. Bugzy Malone!
Yeah, yeah.
This is him. This
my
is
man,
the guy.
My
Look
man.
At him. Come, my bro.
My brother. Good to meet you, bro.
Whoa. You know how long I've been wanting to meet you?
You know
said,
how long?
They said.
Aaron Ramsdale,
yes,
man.
Nice to meet you, brother. How are you?
How's it going?
Good to meet you, my man.
When I see my guy, it's always like it's dripped out. Everything's just like slick and clean.
My brother.
Yes. Come on, let's go sit down, man. I'm going to start you with the high of like the derby and the rivalry. How was it leading into the game?
The Tottenham game?
Yeah. What was the pressure like? What was the pressure?
Yeah, it's the most pressured game, but compared to last year, it was such a completely different feeling because what we were on such a high.
Yeah.
Obviously, the pressure comes from
you know something
families and stuff, but
was it? Yeah, but could you feel it leading up? Was the
yeah,
fans?
Yeah, everything.
Fans
everything's changed, man. Everything.
Yeah.
Everything changes.
Everyone gets serious, don't they? Let me see if I've got the video because I was watching some of your stuff. What was the atmosphere like? It was amazing.
Yeah, it wasn't as good last year though. Last year was the loudest I've ever experienced at their place.
In towards Harry Kane. Good save from Ramsdale.
Was you happy with that, Edda? Because like, I don't think he could get that past your right hand because he's too far past the first post. This is the save. This is the save. Do you think when he's taken that and he's hit you, do you think you've saved it or you think it's still going in?
No, I knew I got enough on it. I knew where I was.
Is that the one you wanted to make sure that you was like flying it?
Like, do you know though? No, obviously you get like your personal accolades, man of the matches and things, but like when it says Arsenal v Tottenham, that's special, isn't it?
It is special.
At Tottenham.
So, Bugs, when's the music start? When's the lyrics start to come? What's going on? Where are we?
So I've always been good at earning a few quid, you know, buying and selling things, just early business stuff.
Did you do that because you wanted it for the look of everything or did you do it because family needed stuff as well?
Yeah. Yeah. The life I come from, it's like, you're struggling for dough and everything around you is falling to bits. You better figure out how to make some dough.
Right.
So when I'm 12, 11, there was some golf course you could get to if you want, miles. I used to go to the golf course, ask them if they needed someone to carry a bag and that, I'd carry the bag. Do you know what I mean? And then flipping life kind of fell to bits. And then you're in a different life and situation. So I chose to earn a few quid and go into music. That's what I was interested
in doing. How did that come about, the going to music? Why all of a sudden?
So like when we was young, we used to kind of just be out on the streets and that's how everyone would express themselves.
With lyrics to each
lyrics.
Other? Freestyling.
Freestyling. Some better than others.
Yeah.
Like I wasn't one of the ones that could just be off the top of my head. I'd have to think about what I was going to say and all that. And then some guys off the top of their head would just be doing madness. So just started from a place of, I'm having a bad time of it. And I want to express myself, do you know what I mean? Well, anytime like we went somewhere and I'd start spitting, the way I spit is like telling a story.
Right.
So it would capture people's imagination. So I'd always get comments like, you're sick of that. And then we seen a few of the London boys was earning a few quid.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I think I was just the first one with the confidence to try and push over and compete with them. But before it was like a London centric, there was nobody from outside of London. You know, I was coming to Notting Hill.
What, you'd make tunes, thing it, and then you'd
put them on a CD.
Right.
I'd brand it up. I'd come to London with like a suitcase, I'm not lying, and I'd just be handing out CDs. I didn't even know why I was doing it. I'll just get proactive, man. I'm not going to sit around and wait for my music career to take off. Especially when I'm from Manchester, where there's not one other rapper making money.
I think my first song with you is probably Relegation Rhythm.
Okay.
2016, 15.
So that's what I'm saying. I'm doing a flipping fire in the booth.
Yeah.
And I'm disagreeing with what Chipmunk's saying. Because Chipmunk is talking about, you know, I got A's in school, I got B's in school, but this fire in the booth platform, to us as Northerners, we can't get on there, we can't get took serious. Mm. So now to see Chip using that platform to talk and going about, I got A's, I got B's, I'm thinking, I was in jail when I was 16. I didn't get to do my A's and B's, but I want to be smart like you. You get me? We kind of respected him. So when I've done my fire in the booth, I disagreed with the things he said, you know, and that was just me as a street guy. I wasn't really trying to diss nobody. Right. That was just me as a street guy feeling resentful of the lack of chances I felt like I had.
Opportunities.
Yeah. But you're trying to give a good account
of yourself. It's the most viewed ever fire in the booth.
The most viewed ever.
Is that the sink or swim moment for you?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, because what you're doing before then is what I've done is I put a campaign together every year for 5 years. Mixtape for free. Just trying to get an audience of some description. Right. Do you get me? Eventually, it got to a stage where I thought I was going to quit.
What year would that have been?
I don't know, just before it took off, so like 2015 or something.
Right.
And I had this one fan that used to pop up in my feed, he used to love me. I didn't think it was that good at the time, do you know what I mean? I'm thinking, that, I thought it sounds all right, but not really grabbing an audience like these London guys do. So I was going to put it in an email. I was going to ask him for his email address and send him my last album. I wasn't going to give it
out. And then that was your farewell?
It was going to be, because I felt like he was the only one listening consistently. So by the time I get an opportunity like Fire in the Booth, are you mad?
Did you recognise that this is it?
Yeah. I'm turning up to take the roof off this thing. I'm not interested. And I start.
And you did it?
So we say.
So, Aaron, in respect of, like, Bugzy talking about the confidence you have to just getting it done, I see a certain confidence in you that is really quite admirable. Where's it come from?
Rejection. So, I got rejected from Bolton.
How old was you?
15. So, I'd gone there from 10 to 15, then went to 10, 11 different teams.
Wow.
All said no.
It's a lot of rejection, bro.
Yeah. Some of the reasonings were, like, I didn't fill my shirt enough at 15. So then my dad, being my dad, said, get him a smaller shirt. You know, it's like, at the time when I was 15, I was probably about 5'6". So people were probably blinded than what's in the future.
Right.
Everything was just right in front of them. And saying, no one was taking that chance. Then you're basically a crossroads, aren't you? You know what it's like.
Yeah.
You go one way of giving up or trying.
Did you get to the giving up road? Did you think,
Nah. I got to the point of staying in like a service station hotel with my dad, like going from like one club one day to the next club.
Was your dad there in that low moment at Bolton?
Yeah, mum and dad.
What happened in that? Because like, you're lucky, you had your parents there. How's that pan out? Were they just like, oh, don't worry, it's going to be fine, you keep going. What was it?
Mum was like that. Dad told me some, like, truths. Yeah.
What did he say? You weren't good enough on the day?
No, it might not make it at some point. Not that I wasn't good enough. At that point, where he's like, this might not happen, so get your head around it.
How do you feel now, but when you look back at it, you must feel good now?
I wouldn't change it.
You wouldn't?
No.
You needed that?
Because I needed it, and I've also, again, that's my perspective now is, there's a lot of people who come straight into a big team, and if they lose, it changes their plans. And I've heard Jamie Carragher speaking on a podcast about he couldn't get over if they had a bad performance. Yeah. He couldn't go out in public.
Mm-hmm.
If I'd have done that for the first 2 years of my career, I wouldn't have seen the light of day other than training.
Right.
So I've been able to put aside football when it needs to, and I can come out and be myself.
What you got for us, Buzz?
Out of nowhere.
Come on, man, let's play it, bro.
Hey. This is a new one.
Yeah. Been in the charts for about 4 months or something. Hey.
Get right, you man.
It's a young kid from Sheffield.
He made a beat.
Hang on.
Yeah.
Check it out.
No such thing as turning back right now. It's an attack right now. Everything black right now. Don't get it twisted about the pop right now.
Stop my beat,
stop my crown. King of the Nizzy, I'll rep my town. My tribe, I kept my crown. It's pink for these industry geeks. I'm a G from the streets, are you mean? Are you mean?
Bro, tell me the story of the song,
I'm just
bro.
Being proud to be from flipping the bottom. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Proud to be from the bottom. I've worked hard. And now we're flying.
So who's this young kid from Sheffield, bro?
Some young kid from Sheffield that's done what I've done and tried. He's reached out for me. I've seen him. He's in his mum's bedroom.
Right.
Making beats. They sent me the thing on TikTok. I just responded as if to say, yeah, yeah. So now that kid's in the charts now with me. Do you get me?
Hang on, bro. Let's hear him again.
This goes off in the change room as well.
Use my pain. He thinking I had to use my brain. I'm a main man, see me in a plain Jane. The Litty Committee don't play no game. No, the Litty Committee don't play no games. No, if I have to cut me,
I was hustling in the cold.
So he got in touch with you and bam, you gave him a bring in.
I just turned up at his mum's house, me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's sick, man.
Got my verse ready, turned up at his house. Done a little video in his bedroom. Everyone's just lost the red. And he's talented, man. Listen to the beat.
Let me listen to the beat.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Bring a beat back.
Heavy.
And then I came up out of nowhere.
What's it like reading the stuff when people are saying, oh my God, Arsenal have just signed Aaron Ramsdale, and you know, what was you thinking coming into Arsenal?
Quickly turned all my comments and social media mentions and stuff off.
Because obviously I was getting a lot of abuse and stuff, but I came knowing full well that I have the capabilities of playing for the football club. I had two relegations. So my first 2 years in Premier League football was relegating.
Mm.
I came to a football club where no one else has had a relegation from the Premier League.
No.
So that was my experience.
Yeah.
I was taking that pressure and that disappointment and bringing it to Arsenal. And at the start, I was thinking, pressure, making top four. That's not pressure.
Mm.
At the start.
Right.
This is pressure. I've seen people losing their jobs because we've been relegated.
Oh, is that happened?
Yeah. Like, football is not just the 11 players on the pitch, which a lot of people forget. There's so many people going back from people doing tickets in the stadium and cleaners and chefs and everything. That's the dark side, and yeah. I've seen all that firsthand.
So can you enjoy it, like, now, with what's happening as Arsenal's number one, challenging hard for the England number one? Can you appreciate being in the moment and enjoying the moment?
Absolutely. A career can end tomorrow for a footballer.
Mm.
No matter if you're 18, 34 or what, like, something could happen and it's done. Why shouldn't I be able to enjoy it? I think with the experiences I had, I've been able just to compartmentalise everything about football rather than being in this little bubble.
Do your thing.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, he's gone for pace.
Tongue's out.
Oh my God, you've done this before. He's gone. Ah, he went to two out. He's gone. See, look, see, when you see the pressure, when somebody says, someone show it like this. What did I get? 140 odd. Oh, he's not going to make it. He's not going to make it, I don't think. Oh, I'll put him under and he's come forward. Oh, my God.
Can I serve this?
Wow.
All right.
Do you have a rivalry with a striker?
Not striker. I just want to keep all of them out.
But yes.
My rivalries come from all my friends.
Is it?
Yeah, so, like, Trent Alexander-Arnold, like... I can't let him score. he's like one of my closest friends, and that is like a major challenge for me. It's them types, like, who I've grew up with in and around football.
Who do you look up to now, Aaron? Like the strikers, the goalkeepers. Who's your inspiration to say, right, I've got to do all this because I want to be England's number one and that? So who's your mentors?
Well, the goalie, David Seaman.
David Seaman.
He was sick.
The goalie,
he's become a bit of a mentor for me.
Anybody who's playing now, you can say, yeah, I like him.
Alisson's a very good one.
Yeah.
He always has time for Liverpool, and he's probably a one where you see his like mentality, nothing will faze him. Mistake, yes. Goals, and he's so, he's the goalie I look at mentality-wise, and I'm like, that's where I want to get to. Mm. Marcus Rashford.
Yeah.
Everything about him, from what he'd done, from how he grew up, what off the pitch.
Yeah, yeah. He's the guy.
Although we're the same age, he's probably like someone I look to and be like, I wish I could be like you, sort of how you are on and off the pitch.
Yeah.
He's brought everything together from where he's come from, what he's doing in and around Manchester and for other people.
It's true, yeah, Marcus is the guy.
Yes.
But you know something, Bugs, I've got to say, there's a kind of like a look in your eye that is so focused, bro. You're getting ready to go again. What's next?
It's an interesting question, just because what I'm interested in is becoming a master. And my purpose, it feels like I can kind of speak to people in a way that they understand. So I can put certain points across, you know. So I'm interested in being at the top of any field that I'm in. Mm. If I'm a rapper, I'm going to be the best in the country. That's where I'm aiming to be. You know, I'm always looking for new records, new titles. Because what's happened now is, now I've ended up in Guy Ritchie films and just been exposed to masters.
Yeah.
Masters of the craft. I've just climbed all the way up to the ladder. So I'm just learning loads. So now I've got a lot to say. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I speak our language. A struggler's language is what I speak. So in my whole thing is trying to demonstrate to people that start where we started that it can happen. I just tried to tell stories that made people understand how to deal with depression or anxiety or street situations or, you know. So that was kind of my gift back to my supporters. And it's just been that all the way up.
Nice.
Because eventually you earn a few quid and you think you can do this on repeat or you can try and offer people something back.
Yeah.
So I wanted to inspire people. That felt to me like the most valuable gift I could give.
See? What are you playing in the dressing room at the minute, Az? What's going on? What are you playing in there?
Rob Holding's our DJ.
Is he?
He'll contribute for everyone, you know. So, like, got some Brazilians, Portuguese, so, like, we get everything.
I call Rob now, Rob Holdinho.
Yeah, and he gets everything going. Obviously, we want to get pumped for a game. Uh-huh. You're going to put something with that sort of bass on, you know.
I like that bass.
Thank you so much.
Bugs, thanks, my friend.
I love you, bro. Yeah,
love you. Nice one, man. I'm so pleased. Let's go, man. No, it's fine. Come on, let's go. No, it's not a case of...
Nice one, man.